differentiate the two terms? Basically, because we got very confusing information from Everest 2 and Planet. Someone said polyp regression, someone said polyp inactivation, someone said complete regression, and you have complete disappearance. So that's why we need to know what exactly these terms mean. Now, this article from Everest Report 2 showed us the imaging and grading protocol and baseline characteristics, and all these terminologies are ICG based. Basically, what the group did, they measured the area of the best fit circles around all individual polyps. Quite an exercise, I would imagine, excluding the hypofluorescent halo, which is believed to represent the fluid. And the areas were summed up and derived the total polyp area. And polyp regression relates to this. It's a quantitative measurement. Whereas the total lesion area, what we best know as the greater lesion diameter, is outlined encompassing the branching vascular network, the feeder vessels, as well as the polyps. And this can be done not only on the Heidelberg, it can be done very well on a Visupac as well. And how do we distinctly differentiate based on the polyp regression? If you have complete regression, there are no polyps seen on the imaging. If you have partial regression, there's more than 10% decrease, no change, less than 10% change, increase more than 10%, and this is what was reflected in the study. There was a subsequent study which showed that if polyps showed no change on post-treatment, it was characterized as no regression. If size reduction was more than half, it was grouped as regression. All these are ICG angiographic findings. So this is an example of a patient with a complete regression on ICG. You see the vascular network with the polyps, and post-treatment they disappear. This is complete regression, whereas in this case you see there are some more polyps still active, and this is incomplete or partial regression. This is one of my own patients, and this is the period from June 2015 to January 2018, a patient with a small polypoidal network, active polyps, and this is January 2018 when you see the lesion has totally disappeared. But what happened in between? You see the first treatment, after the first treatment, polyps disappeared, they reappeared, again appeared, disappeared, reappeared a little bit different location, and then finally disappeared altogether, indicating that just polyp regression alone may not be a sign of complete resolution. This is another patient. You see a large amount of, you see the branching vascular network or the abnormal vascular network coming from the peripapillary region, active polyps on ICG here, going above the disc. A partial regression, about half of them have gone away after treatment. And then this is after multiple treatments, you see there are barely any polyps visible. So this is the endpoint of complete regression of polyps, but you still see the vascular network is persistent. Can we do this on OCTA? Yes, you can, but it's sometimes helpful to have a combined OCT as well. Here you see a patient with a large vascular network, and you see these tips of the polyp which are active just adjacent to a serosanguinous pigment epithelial detachment. This is pre-treatment and post-treatment. You see there's good regression of the polyps, but the vascular network persists. So polyp regression does not actually mean the endpoint of treatment. Now, what about polyp activation and polyp inactivation? This was a study, this was an article by Dr. Yanuzzi in 1999, where they described active PCV and inactive PCV. So the term inactivation means conversion of the active polypoid lesions into inactive lesions. And how do you differentiate them? You look at this picture here. This is one of my own patients. You have a vascular network. You have some lesions at the periphery all around, but some lesions are much brighter than the other. These are the active lesions, whereas the hyperfluorescent rim with a central ecolucent core is actually the inactive lesion. And this was the study that described inactivity of polyps after previous treatment as the absence of polyps on ICGA, or if they were noted by the absence of subretinal fluid around the polyps on OCT. And this helps us because most of us would be following up our patients on OCT. And this was an example that they gave where the polyps disappeared on ICG and also on OCT. This is a patient of mine where we see Post-treatment, the polyps are persisting, but the fluid has gone away. So this is an example of a polyp inactivation. Now, what can OCTA do? We've been discussing this so far. Can it show us something better? This is a study done on patients who appeared to be resistant to treatment, and OCTA is easy, you can do it frequently. So this was the patient after multiple sessions of treatment. This was the patient just before combination therapy. At 1 week, you see there is complete regression even of the vascular network, which is something we don't always see, and starts reappearing again. And then finally, at the end of 2 months, the entire lesion comes back. So this is something the OCTA tells us, that maybe the branching vascular network does regress and then comes back later. This is again another OCTA from the same study showing that complete regression about a week after treatment and reappearance of the lesion later. Just a word of caution when we look, I'll just take maybe a few seconds more. When we look at lesions like this and look only at polyp regression, you see this patient, April 2005, January 2006, you see the polyps appear to be regressing with multiple treatments. This is what the OCT shows, everything looks nice. September 2017, a small recurrence. And what happens in January 2018? There's another lesion here. When we talk about polyp regression, we forget there may be a vessel growing in this direction also. So polyp regression alone may not be the way to go. Thank you.